adventures. You've definitely been with the OGs. You've definitely been in you know, where most people want to go, but basically don't want to go. What's your thing?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you look forward to it all your life, and then when you finally get there, you kind of look at it like, wow, I'm going to come back. I actually made it. I felt like, you know, the first time I went, I was like, oh, wow, I graduated. You know, this is like, this is like.
That's funny because so many kids right now, especially me growing up, I felt like, I never really felt like I had to go to prison, but I did feel that the people who did go to prison was kind of like on top of me. Like they are a little bit more powerful than me. That was just me as a kid, though. I mean, now I think it'll be different, but
yeah. Yeah, me, no, I was just someone that I inherited through my genes, you know. And,
yeah.
And passed on from generation to generation, all experience, you know. And actually, really, you know, really, like I said, you know, like really, in a search on quest for like a better life, you know.
Yeah.
And now this is the generation where I kind of like break that cycle, you know, and make a way for all of us, all of our children, all of our youth to look, to have something to look forward to that's positive, you know, because I don't want to be giving that impression that, oh, he was just gangster, he was jail, he was prison, he was too.
There's a lot more gangsterness than being gangster, right?
Yeah, like after you get to that certain extent and it's like, okay, now I'm dead and now what am I going to do now, you know? And then God brings you back, like, you know, say for instance me, brings me back and then I'm like, okay, you know, like, I already did all these things that I thought were cool.
So
now, on the reverse mode of that, it's like, what am I going to do now? Like, how do I really get a job?
Yeah.
You know, I worked about maybe a year in my whole life, you know,
yeah.
Low-key, high-key, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, other than that, it's just being grinding.
But you actually worked for 7 years because you were in jail working for the system.
You know, I'm a carpenter. I'm a carpenter.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a man of all trades.
So you were saying that you learned that inside, right? You learned a lot about yourself in there, what you liked, and
yeah, for sure, yeah.
You learned about being an architect.
Oh, yeah, an architect, a carpenter, a Freemason,
a Freemason? This is like Illuminati stuff, Chino, what's going on here? Somebody in the comments said, they killed Chino, and this is a clone from Illuminati. Is that where the Illuminati comes in, the Freemasons?
Jesus Christ comes in. Jesus Christ comes in and brings you back for believing in him.
Well, it's crazy because they said that they killed Chino and they brought Illuminati. You told me a story that you went through that process. Like, you technically died
in jail. Not in jail. Out here, I was kind of like running them up.
Well, there was a picture of you on Instagram when you have, you're in a hospital, you have a kind of tooth on you. So I connected that with, okay, this must have been the time that he flatlined.
You know, like, it is a life-changing experience. Like,
so did you flatline?
I mean, I don't know. I went to sleep.